power of the Spirit. Look like I'm talking a long time. I'm getting this over with. I'm almost through. Our programs were a little late getting preached, and I had been given a different theme. Well, when I got here, I see the theme is let God arise and his enemies be scattered. So that's what I'm going to talk about. God arises in our lives and his enemies be scattered. From the 68th Psalm, I'm going to read three verses. So when you get a chance, you read the chapter in its entirety and you'll further understand it. Verse 1 reads, let God arise, let his enemies be scattered. Let them also that hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so drive them away. As wax melted before the fire, so let the wicked perish in the presence of God. But let the righteous be glad. Let them rejoice before God. Yea, let them exceedingly rejoice. And this book was written when Michael God was being moved from house of God at Obed Edom to his new location at Mount Sinai. And this chapter has historical significance, but it also has a great spiritual significance because it shows God in the presence and position of his people. It shows who God is among his people. The first verse begins to let God arise. So first of all, who do we need to arise? We need God to arise. Sometimes we see everybody but God. We look to our friends, we look to our family, and particularly to people who we feel like will be on our side, who will take the same position that we take, but we need to let God arise. The first word also says let. It does not say to make God arise. We can't make God do anything. The more we push and try to get it done, the more weighty it gets, and the longer it takes for it to get done. But if we'll just relax in God and just leave it alone and just pray, have our intercessory prayer, but God already knows the situation, whatever we're going through, God already knows. And if we'll just relax and let God work, then our problems will cease. I believe at a much faster pace. I know it has worked in my life if I can give it to God. And sometimes we can't do that. We just have to hold on to whatever it is that we're going through. It says, let his enemies be scattered. So that's why we need God up front, because he said, his enemies. It didn't say our enemies. It said, let his enemies be scattered. So whatever you're going through, whoever is working against you, and sometimes we have so many problems, or it could be on our job, in our neighborhood, sometimes the next door neighbor is just acting crazy, you know. Okay, even on your job, you may get in a position where maybe you get a new position or you're qualified for a new position, but you don't get it. But you got to remember that when the enemy is working against you and you're a child of God, then they are working against God. So these are God's enemies. You don't have to worry about that. So we don't have to fight that battle because we just give that problem to God. Recognize that if you're a child of God, whatever the enemy does to you, he's doing to God. If not, we take things personal and we get all bent out of shape. I know I do some of that. I just get worried. You know, I don't act up, but I get worried. I get so worried. And I know to give it to God, but it's hard for me to release it. I still don't see how God will handle it, so I still worry about it. So we got to stop worrying about these things and know that these are God's problems, not ours. It's the next one also that hate him, flee before him. I know I have heard lots of testimonies about people. This happens, seems like, particularly on your job. But when things go wrong on your job, and somebody over you will mistreat you, and then they end up losing their job. Well, you know what I'm saying? This scripture said, if they hate him, then you will see them pleading before him. Then, when you know what I'm saying, they won't even be there anymore. They mistreated you, child. you know, sometimes we run up on a, you know, find a big fire, you know, and smoke is everywhere. Sometimes the fire can be so big that smoke can be for miles. You can be coming down the road, and the smoke is way far. You can see. You can see smoke. You can't even see the origin of it sometimes. But just as that smoke leaves the origin of the fire, so is it. So for these people, and their problems never make a rattle away from you. So as wax melted before the fire, you know, recently we had a storm and my lights went out. So we had to use candles, you know. So we used some candles, had candles in the house. But I had one candle that was called a meltless, waxless candle. You know how the wax will run down the candle. This one doesn't. It's a dripless. That's what it's called. It's called a dripless candle. And that wax just drips down on your candle. This one doesn't. The candle just sit right there, and as we outwashed it from time to time, the candle was getting smaller and smaller and smaller. I didn't see the wax anyway. But it was just staying going away. The wax was going away. So this is what God can do in our lives. If we allow Him to do it. You know, before we know it, our problems, our situations, our sickness, whatever it is, it'll just go away. Sometimes your finances don't look right. But in time, when you give it to God, just tell God what you need. And then, Sister May come up that night, and then we just start rejoicing. You know, tell God about it. You start rejoicing because you believe that God will do it. And before you know it, that thing will be turning around. I know one time my husband and I went to the bank to check our money. And, you know, and usually you check your money because it's running kind of tight. We checked our money, and we had $800 more than we were supposed to have. So you don't go spend all that money, and the first of all, the bank will take it back from the soon you find the error anyway. So we went to the bank, and we reported it. And they told us that they didn't see what the problem was. It looked like it was our money. I don't know when it went in there. I can't remember all those details that they told us that, but they said it looked like it was our money. So we waited. And we waited, and we waited, and we trust God, and we spent that money. And I pray God will do it. He will give you money that you didn't even know you had. God will do it. He will give you right. I've had so many conditions in my own life. I know that my knees are bad now, and I'm waiting on God to take care of that for me. But you know, I had heel spur one time. And I had a hard time walking on that thing. I went to the doctor, and he wasn't much hope. He wasn't much help either, and he didn't give me hope for these heel spurs. But when I know these things, they were gone. They were gone because God took care of it. There have been many conditions in my body that God has taken care of. When I was 16 years old, I believed that my appendix burst. And we can go to the doctor then. My parents raised up on that blessed oil. We did not go to the doctor. So and I was sick. I mean, I was terribly sick. But God is so wise that He allowed this to happen to me during the summer. I didn't have to miss a day out of school because God took care of that. It was during the summer. I was sick. I was so sick. I couldn't stand up. I was bit halfway over. And you know how the old people would say, you know, the bed will make you weak, you know, take the strength. So I would have to get up and go to the living room.